years, ICDO has established fruitful collaboration with the Afghanistan community in Vienna and worldwide, promoting its diversity and culture at the long nights of interculturality and other activities. Deeply concerned with the recent developments of the events in Afghanistan, it is our utmost pleasure to host a woman who is at the forefront of fighting for women's rights and gender equality in Afghanistan. Your Excellency, Mrs. Manizha Bakhtari, Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of the Embassy of the Islamic Republic of Afghanistan in Vienna, Austria. Welcome and thank you for joining us here today.
Thank you so much for having me. My life has been defined by my career and my freedom to pursue, and as an individual who has witnessed the gains achieved in women's rights and human rights over the past 20 years, I cannot lie to you, I'm devastated. Personally, it breaks my heart to see my beautiful country, my fellow Afghans, and my inspiring women colleagues once again sent into such unstable conditions. Professionally, my views are irrelevant. Yes, my career as a diplomat and ambassador will be over. I will never work for the Taliban, nor do I have any interest in working with the next regime. At the same time, they do not have the space for women, and they do not provide opportunities for women. But I'm extremely fortunate in my current position. I'm safe in a country that respects human rights. My children and my immediate family are safe as well, so this is not about me. I will be fine. The most pressing issue for me and for my colleague is the well-being and safety of women and children in Afghanistan who have been forced to reckon with the sudden loss of their freedom and rights. For the past 20 years, Afghans have made incredible progress, particularly women. School attendance of boys and girls skyrocketed from zero girls attending school in 2000 to 3.5 million attending school in 2019. Just the basic level of education of all our young people was elevated, boys and girls. Women became doctors, judges, diplomats. Afghanistan flourished. Afghanistan is home to the youngest population in the world. 74.6% of Afghans are under the age of 15. These young Afghans are the future of our country, though education cannot remedy the current situation. We must continue to give our young people the tools they need to build a brighter future for themselves and for Afghanistan. Our current reality has changed, and I'm a realist. Though I remember the brutality of the Taliban's last rule, I hope for everyone's sake that the Taliban will keep their promise to constitute an inclusive government for all Afghans. And I hope that they will respect the progress and achievements made in the last 20 years. I hope that the Taliban recognize the new realities of this world and adhere to the international standards of human rights and women's rights. I hope that they gain appreciation for the talents and abilities of Afghanistan's young women, and that they do not take away the freedom that we have worked so hard to exercise. To be completely honest with you, my personal and my professional experience leaves me with little hope that the Taliban will meet the standards of the international community. But as we say in Afghanistan, the ditch where water has flowed, it would flow again. Future policies must approve the Taliban regime with caution. As we all know, action speaks louder than words, and I encourage all those who would engage with the Taliban to judge them on their actions rather than the pretty words of their spokespersons. The significance of freedom of press and freedom in media cannot be understated. Without it, how can a citizen expect to be truthfully informed? The Taliban must also understand that the country they now control is not the Afghanistan they knew 20 years ago. To be taken seriously as a governing body must immediately improve their positions towards journalists and the media. Without freedom of press, nothing broadcast from Afghanistan can be trusted. The Taliban must realize that new newscast featuring heavily armed Taliban Taliban soldiers in the background have no journalistic integrity. I want to make it clear to the entire world, without the support of the international community, there will be no cultural and religious diversity in Afghanistan. Afghanistan is an ancient land and attaches great importance to cultural diversity. The only future in which Afghanistan's cultural and religious diversity can flourish is a future with an inclusive government that supports the rights of Afghans to live and worship however they choose. Our society is founded upon our rich cultural heritage. Without it, we have nothing. The population of Afghanistan must be reassured that their freedom will be upheld. Afghans currently face enormous challenges. The situation in Kabul and the entire country is extremely insecure, and people are afraid for their lives and their families. The Taliban are not currently equipped to provide the services Afghans need right now. Borders are closed and Afghans cannot access food or medical care that's already in very short supply. Banks are not operating and people have no money. The currency is depreciating at a drastic rate. People need food, they need medical care, they need shelter. Regardless of the political situation in Afghanistan, regardless who rules in the country, the assistance of the international community is desperately needed on the ground. Once the humanitarian issues have been addressed, then the international community can begin to assess the viability of the Taliban's attempt at governing. When it comes to NGOs' role, I must say NGOs will be sorely needed as the situation develops. Currently, the best things that anyone can do is to help evacuate vulnerable people and provide them with the support that the support they need to restart their lives. NGOs can help to lobby governing officials to grant visas for journalists, for women rights activists, scientists, and students. They can supply organizers on the ground in Afghanistan with food and medical supplies. They can use their networks to push for expanded resources for Afghan refugees already settled abroad and provide free language classes and vocational training. NGOs like ICDO can help break down cultural barriers and support policies that push for inquiries into human rights abuses in Afghanistan. They can simply raise awareness of the current situation and keep doing so. Right now, the world's eyes are upon Afghanistan. The world must not look away. I will not give up the fight for democracy, for women's rights, for human rights, and for the values of the Republic of Afghanistan. Though I cannot change the situation, I will do everything in my power to champion the rights of Afghans to pursue happy and healthful lives in peace and safety. I will not stop calling attention to the difficulties faced by Afghan women as they reckon with their new reality. I urge all of my colleagues in the international community, my colleagues in the diplomatic community in Vienna, my friends throughout Austria and Europe. This is why the international community exists. This is why we put the work and to build these relationships transitionally. We are all global citizens and Afghans need your help. Please use your platforms to advocate for Afghan women and fight for their rights and freedoms.
Thank you so much, Ambassador. This was a very, very honest and very touching insight that you have provided us. And we are happy to share these words through ICDO platforms and in Europe and beyond. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much for having me and for having my message, because I believe right now Afghan women do not have a voice. Those Afghans who are inside Afghanistan. So we need to use international platform as yours to raise voice, to advocate for Afghan women's rights, for women's education, for the democracy, for the values, and for the achievements we have gained for the past two decades. And not only that, we should put conditions for the Taliban, international community should put conditions for the Taliban to acknowledge and to consider all the values and all the, and they should acknowledge the achievements, the freedom, the democracy, the freedom of media, freedom of expression, because that is the new reality of the world. That is the new reality of Afghanistan. Afghanistan has a new generation, and they should listen to the new generation voices. They cannot just shut everyone up, because that's not the way they should do. So thank you guys for having me.
Thank you. Thank you.